I'm here at the mouth of the Pinconning River, and today we're going to be learning about European frogbit, which is an invasive species in the Great Lakes. And we're going to be talking to some CMU researchers about what they're learning about the frogbit and how they're helping to combat this problem. So I'm going to put on these waders and I will meet you in the river. So this right here is our European frogbit. As you can see, it is very long and tangled. It is actually kind of like soft and fun to touch, but it doesn't smell very good. This invasive species makes it really hard for recreational activities like kayaking, boating, fishing, and then also it can be very damaging to the environment for both our native plants and animals here. I'm with Dan Rebar, and we are here talking about European frogbit, and he's going to show us a little bit about their equipment that they use.
Yeah, absolutely, Sophie. So we use a good range of equipment. The first and one of the most important pieces of equipment that we have is obviously the kayaks.
Okay.
So we definitely use these to get around a lot. Most of the sites that we go to are fairly inaccessible on foot, so we need these to get around. This is perhaps our most important piece right here. This is very simple. It's just a little quadrat. It's about 0.1 meters squared. This is called a YSI probe. This is very high tech. And so what this is it has two pieces to it. This is a probe and this is just a monitor. And so this piece will go down into the water column and it gives us a reading of different water quality parameters. So things like temperature, pH, dissolved oxygen content, all of which are pretty relevant to what we're sort of looking at and give us an idea of the site's characteristics itself.
Awesome.
And then the last piece of equipment here is just your standard GPS with all of our different sites around the state that we look at. Okay. We go back to these plots usually once a month.
This is really heavy. I mean, I'm really weak, but oh my gosh. And look, this is all, it's all interconnected. So now I'm with Blake Cahill, who is a PhD student at CMU, and he's gonna take me through how they actually use all this equipment.
Yeah, so once we arrive to the site using that GPS unit, and we collect 10 of these quadrat samples at each of our sites during each of our visits. And we use a quadrat to collect the data so that we can get a representative idea or estimate of what's happening at the site with frogbit and with the habitat that frogbit is occurring in. We'll take our YSI probe and just record some basic water quality parameters. But once we're done with that, we then will move on to our frogbit specific data collection. So the first thing we'll do is estimate what's called percent cover, and that's just the percent of the surface of the water that's being covered by frogbit. Once that's complete, we move into more of the destructive sampling. So we'll cut along the edges of the quadrat, and we have to do this cutting because if you try to pull any of this up, it is all connected and you can't get a accurate sample when it's connected like that. We'll take this sample, we'll rinse it off in the water, and once it's rinsed, we will count all of the individual plants in here, which is a time-consuming process. And we'll also count some of the reproductive structures. So for example, this is a European frogbit fruit.
Okay.
And this develops from the flowers that I showed you previously when they're fertilized. But once we do the rinsing and the counting of each of these biomass samples, we'll bag them, store them in a cooler, and bring them back to our site access or our boat launch. And there we actually weigh all of our samples.
I really don't know how they do it, how they get all of this untangled. That's like talent. And so what's the goal kind of with this research once you are able to analyze it?
Yeah. So we actually at CMU, the Monfils Lab, spearheads an initiative called the EFB Collaborative. Oh. And so that's a big group that involves obviously our lab, but also a number of other groups in the state. And then we also partner with a couple, they're called Cooperative Invasive Species Management Areas. And so those are the people who are really going to take the data that we develop and they're gonna use that and leverage that to put forth the best management practices and really hopefully get the CFB under control a little bit.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much for letting us come hang out with you guys for a day and showing us around. And well, that's a wrap, y'all.